now what do we got?
Well, our last plant today is the hibiscus, which I think a lot of people are familiar with. Once again, this grows into huge proportions down south. Georgia and Florida, they're trees. They come in a variety of colors. They would like the sunniest window you can give them. You want to try to reproduce the tropical environment. Warm, sunny, as warm as you can get it almost. Try not to get them in the draft of a window if possible.
So a nice south or west window would be ideal for them. And they can live outside during the summer. You can keep them in a pot outside if you'd like, in a semi-shady place is what I've found to be the best for them. And then you can bring them back in the winter time. Well, actually, you want to do it before winter, but for the winter. Bring them in around September 15th and put them back in the sunny window, and they'll be fine. I have one at home that has bright, hot pink blossoms, and it's bloomed all throughout the winter, but it's sitting right in front of its south window.
That would be a good home for
them. Yeah, yep. That's the place for them. Now, as far as watering goes,
once again, this one, well, with this particular plant here, because of the size container, we're in only a 6-inch pot, and I imagine it's fairly filled with roots. I would even consider repotting shortly. Once again, barely let the soil surface go dry before you water. And then it would, once again, don't let it sit in water, but do water thoroughly. And this is another one that tends to benefit from having its blossoms plucked after they are spent, and that will encourage more buds. You can see the buds coming
on. That's true. It does have quite a few coming up. They do have gorgeous flowers. Now, this looks a little bit different than the variety I've seen. Its petals are a little more raggedy. It kind of gives it a fluffier
look. A ruffled look, right.
In fact, I
chose it because it was a little bit different. Thought we might enjoy that.
Oh, it's nice. Now, what about fertilizer on this? Again, do you think the blossom booster?
Yes, I think for 99% of your blooming plants that aren't acid-loving, with the exception of African violets or gardenias, I like the blossom booster. I use it at home and have good results.
Great. Now, these plants are somewhat susceptible to mites, aren't they?
They are to mites and also aphids, particularly if you put them outside during the summer. You can do the same mite test that you used on the gardenia. But for your aphids, you want to check in the new growth in the bud area, where the tender, you can see the light green where the buds and the new growth is. They tend to cluster there. They can be, like the blossoms, all colors of the rainbow, red, green, gray, pink, black. And you'll see them in clusters. They can produce as much as 20 generations in one season, so they're quite prolific. The safers will take care of it, and this won't hurt the plant. You don't have to use any special kind of safers to take care of it.
The good news is that aphids are pretty easy to get rid of, fortunately.
Yeah.
They may be ugly, but they go away pretty easily.
These plants can get huge. My upstairs neighbor has one in an unheated kind of glassed-in foyer that's a good 7 feet tall and a 14-inch pot and is just covered in buds almost year-round.
That's amazing.
But it gets warm and you don't have to worry about taking it in and out. It's a great situation for them.
So if you've got a special spot like that, you can really end up with a tree almost.
Oh, more than trees. They're great.
They are beautiful.